Hi everyone, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to tell you 11 things that you can sell on Etsy as a digital download. So this means no shipping products out. The customer on the other end can just buy your product on Etsy and then download it, and then they print it out or use it however it's supposed to be used. So first up is printable planner pages. Kind of hard to say. And these are just usually a week spread, and they're usually in a PDF format, but bullet journals have gotten so popular that people on Etsy are starting to see a need to sell these. And so let's take a look at what's out there. Some of them are actually pretty plain, but a lot of them have some really interesting designs and are quite beautiful. Okay, the second thing that you can sell on Etsy is digital prints. So these are basically just drawings and stuff that look really nice, and people want to put them up in their homes. So they'll buy it, they'll download it, and they'll take it to a nice printer or maybe even print it off at home, and then frame it and put it up on their wall as decoration. So let's take a look at some of these digital prints. There are flowers, animals, a lot of quotes are popular. Here are a few city ones. These look really nice. So if you're really good at illustration, you can just create that stuff once and then keep on selling the digital prints without having to do any extra work. All right, next up is scrapbooking papers. And these are along the same lines as digital prints. Your end user will actually just print it out as a scrapbook sheet and use it in their scrapbooks, as you may have guessed. All right, let's take a look at some of these. These are also sold as bundles most of the time. Here's a wood paper bundle for only $2, and you get about, looks like 12 of them, 14. You have to be willing to put in a lot of time and effort to get really nice complete sets because they don't sell for very much, so you have to have a lot of people who want them. Next up is resume templates. Pretty much everyone needs a resume template so that they can get a job, right? So we as designers can make them look really great and put them in a format that's easy for anyone to use, and they have the software too, probably. Like, a lot of people design in Word, and I guarantee you, I mean, there's nothing that drives designers more crazy than trying to design something in Word. But once you get it figured out, you can actually sell that template over and over. So let's take a look at some of these. And these are just templates. So this means that the end user will have to personalize and customize these themselves. The next thing you could try to sell on Etsy is digital photography. Now, it doesn't really seem to sell that well or be that popular on Etsy, but there are a lot of other places you could sell your digital photos, like Shutterstock, a lot of the stock websites, Adobe Stock, iStock, all of those. And you can make a pretty good little side income with that. When we look out here for these digital photos, I'm not seeing a lot of really high quality stuff, but hey, why not give it a shot? Another thing that's really gained a lot of popularity recently on Etsy is mockups, specifically clothing mockups. So if you're a mockup designer and photographer, you would just create a backdrop and then style some t-shirts and some boots possibly, some pants, and have it a whole little outfit. And then a t-shirt designer can just drop their designs on that mockup. Let's take a look on Etsy and see what's popular in this category. A lot of times it has to do with what season it is. So here's a fall related theme, some that are more summer, and kids t-shirts and onesies are really popular too. Another digital download that is really popular on Etsy is fonts. I use a software called FontSelf. It's actually a plugin for Illustrator or Photoshop. And it's just really great because it is so easy. All you do is create your alphabet in Illustrator, and then you just drop it onto this plugin and it makes an OTF file for you. By the way, if you are interested in that software, there's a link in my description and you would get 10% off, and I also get a little bit of money because it's my referral link. Anyway, so both people win. It's awesome. Anyway, let's take a look at some of the fonts out there. And here we have a lot of different fonts, and you would get a great deal by only paying $23 for all of these fonts. They look really nice too. I do think font making takes a lot of skill to be able to really turn out really nice ones. So here are a few more. Another huge trend I'm seeing on Etsy is SVG graphics. And these are scalable vector graphics. And the reason they're so popular is because crafters, they usually have a cutting machine. So this might be a Cameo or a Cricut, and they know to follow that SVG cut line. And so if you can make these, they can cut them at home with their cutting machine. So let's take a look at the type of SVG files out there. Some are really ornate. Some are just more fun. Sports related. See a lot of camping ones. And these are definitely more geared towards crafters as opposed to designers. Whereas something like fonts would be geared towards both designers and crafters. Now, if you don't know Illustrator very well and you don't know really how to make SVG graphics, you can just create clipart. And clipart sells really well on Etsy too. When I search here, it shows 648,000 results. So that is a lot of clipart, and a lot of people are making money doing this. So a lot of these are created around a theme. We've got flowers, we've got camping. Camping seems to be a recurrent theme. Food. Your options are basically endless here. All the digital downloads I mentioned so far have been sort of passive, but you can also sell things that are still printable on Etsy, and they can be completely custom. And a good example of that is wedding invitations. So let's take a look at some of these. These generally run a little higher in price point than the other graphics we've seen because someone actually has to customize this. They have to send the file via email. Can't just digital download it off of Etsy. Now, I know we already talked about resumes and resume templates, but you can also sell customized resumes in the same way that you can sell the wedding invitations. Basically, you have to get them to fill out all their information, and then you typeset it for them, and then you send them a PDF. So these also cost, generally speaking, a little bit more because, you know, you have to think about word counts, how many words are going to fit in there, and you have to worry about misspellings and that kind of thing. It's definitely a client and designer relationship, just like freelance would be. So those are 11 things that you can create as a designer and sell on Etsy, and most of them are passive, and that is a great source of just income that you don't even have to think about. It just makes itself. It's not really that easy, but once you get it going, it can be a nice little side income. All right, now, if you like this video, please leave a comment in the comment section below, or if you can think of another thing that is great to sell on Etsy that I forgot, leave a comment in there too, and I'll see you next week with another graphic design video. Thank you.